E olha só, Tosh Meets Marley é a turnê que percorre o mundo homenageando Bob Marley e Peter Tosh. Com um repertório que mescla canções dos dois ícones do reggae, o show tem a participação de Fule Fullwood, baixista original de Pete Tosh, e Junior Marvin, que por anos foi o guitarrista de Bob Marley nos Wailers. Pois a turnê chega hoje a Porto Alegre com um show logo mais na Opinião. Aqui com a gente, esses dois ícones do reggae, Fule Fullwood e Junior Marvin. Yeah, welcome to our show, guys. We are very happy to have you here.
Thank you.
I have to speak in English with you and then translate for them, okay?
Okay, we speak slowly
and slow. Yeah, yeah, that's it. Eu falei que a gente vai falar bem calmamente para traduzir tudo para vocês, ok? Eu vou perguntar primeiro para ele sobre o Bob Marley, como foi conviver com a figura. Well, Bob Marley is one of the most important figures of pop culture of the 20th century. Both of you knew him and worked with him. How was it?
Fantastic. actually, Fully started a long time ago when Bob first started with Peter and Bunny.
Right.
And the original Wailers.
Yeah, and he did songs like Sun is Shining. Played the original bass, yeah. So he's a legend.
He's a legend, man.
He's a legend too.
Well, not.
Yeah. You better translate.
Yeah, então vamos traduzir. O Junior Marvin disse que o Fully tocou na formação original dos Wailers, junto com o Pete Tosh, com o Bunny Wailer. Então que o cara é uma lenda, que eu tô aqui do meu lado com uma lenda viva. Mas o Junior Marvin tá sendo modesto. Well, you play in the late 70s with Marley.
Yeah, I started in 77 with Exodus.
Wow, great album.
I'm so happy. It's voted, Exodus was voted CD of the 20th century. And I'm very proud to be part and to work with Bob, you know.
And how was Bob in personal life out of the stage?
He loved ladies.
Ladies, man.
And football.
cool.
But I think his ambition was to be center forward for Manchester United or somebody. That was his dream, you know. But instead, he played music.
Well, good for us.
I feel him just have a great. I feel him have a that Bob just have a special talent that nobody else, you know. So far as I can see, his talent and his writing and his creative ability was just, I mean, beyond his whole life, you know what I'm saying? So what you see with Bob here, that's the reason why he is so powerful right now, still, over 30 years I'm going, and I think forever too, he's going to be. So it, for me, it was just a true blessing for me to have, you know, share some of my input to, as far as playing and travel with him in Jamaica. You know, playing shows around and in the studio. So I think I was blessed to just share a part of his life.
Yeah. I agree with you.
Yeah.
O Junior falou que tocou com o Bob Marley em 77, com o disco Exodus, que foi considerado um dos grandes CDs do século, né? E o Fully falou que foi abençoado por tocar com o Bob Marley, né? Que ele acredita que o cara tinha uma força muito grande, por isso que hoje, 30 anos depois, ele continua tão vivo ainda na memória das pessoas. E o Junior disse que o Bob tinha duas paixões, mulheres e futebol. Que ele queria, na verdade, ser jogador Manchester United.
It's his dream, you know.
Era o sonho dele jogar no Manchester United, mas que acabou fazendo música, né? E eu comentei, bom, sorte pra gente, né? And if he was alive, what would he think about the world today? This messy world we live.
Yeah, we are not perfect, you know, so we are still learning how to live with each other. And unfortunately, it's taken a long time, but we still have hope for the future.
Yeah, I believe that there sometimes soon in this world, we're going to, as human beings, we're going to realize the problem that the world has, but you know, we're going to overcome that. I just have, just like what Junior said, I have a lot of faith, you know, in humanity. I have a lot of faith in the music, because the music is going to change the world too. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. I just believe that it's going to happen. And I am hoping, you know, love is going to conquer everything. So that's what Bob said in his message and his word and Peter. You know, so we just have to continue the word of hope and the word of love, you know, and unity, and hope that people and the younger generation would share that and share it amongst the older generation, because the youth is the one that is going to change the world.
The youth.
The youth. Yes, yes, for sure.
Fully disse que, eu perguntei se o Bob Marley estivesse vivo, né, hoje, o que ele pensaria desse mundo maluco, né? Eles falaram que eles têm muita esperança, assim como o Bob teria, né, de que o mundo pode ser melhor, e eles acreditam que a música pode transformar o mundo e que o amor pode transformar o mundo e que é o papel dos jovens fazer essa transformação.